Hey everybody, welcome back to another episode of The Drop. I'm your girl Nika B, and my co-host Vonte is not here with me today. Why? Because Vonte, you work just a little bit too much and you decided to leave me by myself today, huh? But nevertheless. But as promised, like I said in the first episode, we will be interviewing more females. And today we have two female DJs, that's DJ Shawn and DJ Stuggy. So we can't wait to hear what they have to say. So here's our first video of the episode. Take a look. Let's get into it.
September 16th, it's the new lineup of ZNS News and Current Affairs, 6 p.m. It's What's Trending, Lifestyles in the Afternoon with Stacey Campbell Marshall, 6:30. We head to the north for the Bahamas Tonight Northern Edition, 7 p.m. It's the Bahamas Tonight National Report, followed by the Bahamas Tonight Access, now at 7:30. Then at 8 p.m., your nightly news analysis show, The Rundown with Clint Watson. And 11 p.m., the Bahamas Tonight at 11 with Royston Jones. It's a full lineup of the new ZNS. And it starts Monday, September 16th. Only the sun covers the Bahamas better.
You're watching The Drop.
Well, welcome back from the break, everybody. And today we have DJ Stuggy in studio with us today. DJ Stuggy, how are you?
I'm wonderful, and you?
I am great. So let's get right into it. Tell us, who is DJ Stuggy?
Okay, DJ Stuggy, I'm a professional DJ. I've been DJing for 12 years. I love to make people feel welcome, enjoy the music as I play.
Who influenced you to DJ?
My father.
Was he a DJ? Was he, what was the household? What filled with music? You just wanted to make music?
We had a club and restaurant, so the only person in the family who could DJ or try to mix music was me. So he got all my equipment and I started playing music from then. What makes me different from other DJs is that I'm more focused on Latin music, Spanish music. So that would actually make the talk of me to say my DJ name and who I am.
Okay, so if I need to get you for Cinco de Mayo, because I like suavemente. Well,
I normally play for Bristol's. All of the Latin events. We normally have the Latin Fiesta.
Yeah,
it's okay, like 2 years, that. 2 years now.
Okay. Yeah. What do you think about other DJs speeding up the BPM of music?
I feel no way about it because with DJing, you play out what you feel. Mm. And with speeding up the BPM, that might be a song where it has probably 130 BPM and the next song has about 120 or 119, then you gotta speed it up. Once it mixing and blending, it's fine.
And then it's the go.
Yeah.
When you're booking your transactions for your gigs and everything, so do you get paid half down? You show up, you don't get paid until afterwards. What's your process like?
It depends on my client. But normally, if it's the first client, deposits will be half down.
Okay. For those other clients, those good old faithful clients.
Yeah, you pay me after. It's fine. I'm trusting them.
All right. Well, DJ Stuggy, thank you for coming on The Drop, letting us interview you. We know you are a busy DJ, so we look forward to hearing more of you. So, well, everybody, we will see you on the next side of The Drop. But first, take a look at this video.
I was just 10 when she told me that she wanted to play. And she was 12, thought it was innocent, I said okay. I was intrigued by the way she would touch my lips and say, don't tell a soul about this, it's our secret, so I kept it safe. And she would kiss me, I would let her, I'm thinking it's nothing. She'd put her hand inside my pants while she's staring and blushing. And then she told me, do the same, still thinking nothing of it. I lost my innocence when I was 10 into my cousin. As I got older, it affected me, I didn't notice. Battling incest at the age of 12, afraid to show it. At 14, lust that took over, I couldn't control it. All I wanted was that same feeling, my cousin awoken. It got worse, I would wake up with the bed full of semen. Pornography and masturbation was my biggest demons. So introverted, I never showed it, inside I'm screaming. Somebody save me from myself, cause I don't wanna be him.
I never wanted to be this way. But if I told you the things I faced, what would you say? I'm so afraid you'll judge me. What if I told you the things I faced? How would you look at me? But if I stay silent, it's better this way.
Let's go. Fast forward, I'm saved now, living for Christ. Rapping from churches to churches, I was good on the mic. Preaching on how to live right, yo, my lyrics were tight. But there was an issue that was never addressed or brought to light. I was still better than lust, and it became worse. Something that happened to me at 10 had followed me to the church. Didn't know how to say no to the women that would flirt. I did my dirt, then picked up the Christian, got back to work. I was anointed, that's what they all got from me. Saved and sanctified, couldn't speak about this here part of me. Cause if I did, I'd be judged for this man I didn't wanna be. Wanted to call on someone, but then so much people called on me. They put me on a stage, I'd say a prayer and do it. Searching for my deliverance, they found it in my music. Putting on facades, knowing the truth make you feel stupid. But you know the kind of looks you'd get if anybody knew it. So you keep it to yourself and try to deal with it. They say prayer changes things, so I went and kneeled with it. Yes, they lied to me saying that I'll feel different. Cause I did the same thing and realized I'm still in it. The church should be a place of vulnerability and aid to the sickly and the ones that's fighting every day. That's community, but truth is the church became a place where we have to hide our flaws, never show them, join the parade. Shut up and give them praise.
I never wanted to be this way. But if I told you the things I faced, what would you say? I'm so afraid you'll judge me. What if I told you the things I faced? How would you look at me? But if I stay silent, it's better this way.
up, Mario?
Hey, Dale, what's going on?
Have you seen ZNS new digital platforms?
No. Let me go check it out.
Good day, Bahamas. I'm Devonte Hanna, and this is ZNS Digital,
where we cater to your news and entertainment needs.
Are you a foodie? I thought so. Then look out for Digital Bites.
Shining a light on Bahamians and the good that they do, ZNS Digital is home to the sunshine room.
Keeping up with the latest trends, our original content will keep you entertained.
Yeah, that's cool.
But have you seen the new website?
No, I didn't see it. Let me go look.
We're still your most trusted source for news and information.
That's ZNS Digital?
Yeah, that's ZNS Digital, the people's station in your pocket.
You're watching The Drop.
Welcome back from the break, everybody. And right now we have DJ Shawn in studio with us today. DJ Shawn, how are you?
I'm good. Thanks for having me.
No problem. So tell us, who's DJ Shawn?
DJ Shawn is a unique individual and a jack of all trades. So I not only DJ, but I do tattoos as well and a few other stuff.
Okay.
Yeah.
So tell us how you got into DJing.
Well, how I got into DJing, straight out of school, I didn't have a job. And there was a bar right across from the street, across the road from us. And I used to go over there every day. And I used to watch the DJ mix and everything, do what he doing. I was like fascinated by it, but I always did like music. So every day I went over, he got used to me and he was like, if I want to give it a try. And so from there, I just was like, yeah, from there, everything just take off.
Okay, so who influenced you to DJ? Like, where did that come from?
Well, I always did like music. Like, I could remember growing up, driving in the car with my mommy. She kind of put me on all the older songs because I would have been younger.
Right.
So that when I DJed at some parties, people be like, "Mom, what you know about that?" I say, "Man, I know more about this than you." Yeah. So I used to be singing in the car with my mommy, and then my daddy liked music too. So he used to be blasting. But my mommy, she really get me into it, and she was like pushing me from the start.
Okay.
Yeah.
What do you think about selectors calling themselves DJs? What's your take on that?
Selectors. I mean, I feel like it should be a difference. I feel like a DJ is a disc jockey, and I feel in my definition of a disc jockey is someone who, you know, use the mixing board. I feel like a selector is just a MC. Like, you know, they just talk on the mic. So, I mean, I don't have no feelings towards it, but I feel like a selector is a selector and a DJ is a DJ. Yeah.
Do you have any preferred parties you like DJing to? Corporate parties, children's parties, like, you know, grown adult parties?
I like grown adult parties. To me, I feel like they're the easiest to DJ to. Like, once you could come with some 90s vibes, some old school, some R&B, and then later on in the night when people then had a few drinks and then, you know, you could pick it up, play some soca, some dancehall and whatnot. Yeah, so I like grown folks, for sure.
What life lessons has being a DJ taught you?
Well, it's definitely taught me to be more patient and more vigilant, like working in the parties and whatnot. You have so much people that come with 1,000 requests. And instead of getting mad or like, you know, some DJs do, like, they really get back at it to it.
Yeah.
You just be like, okay, no problem, 1 second. You just learn to be patient with people.
Mm-hmm.
And then I'll have about 10 different people with different requests, so I have to be so focused. So once I start playing them, I just have to remember in my head, all right, go from this song to that song to that song to that song. So
right.
It really teach me focus too.
Okay, the party
ain't
live enough, and okay. You DJing.
Right.
What is your to-go-to tactic or your to-go-to genre of music to get them started?
Okay. With that, it ain't a particular genre. It would be whatever song in any genre with what I know right now, popping.
Mm-hmm.
So like, even though I might be trying to build up, like I have already in my mind, all right, I can build them up from here. Sometimes you can't please everybody, but you know how to work your way up. And I just pick whatever popular song at the moment, but I know once I play that, everybody can sing or everybody can dance. Even if I just get them for one song and then I can jump back in to my, how I want to build them up.
But I bet you if you play Cash Money, take it over.
Yeah,
exactly. Everybody running to the
exactly,
floor, right?
Yeah.
Okay, so explain, what is the difference between live mixes and pre-mix music.
Okay, a live mix is what you do in the moment. So like once I'm there, I'm mixing that right now. Like that's a live mix. Mm-hmm. A pre-mix is something I could do days before, and I could just make it at home, and when I reach, I could just play it. But it already mixed. I don't have to touch the board at all. So a live mix, you doing it in person, and a pre-mix you could do before time.
So when you mix the music, your pre-mix, right? Mm-hmm. Do you post it on SoundCloud? Like you post it on TikTok? How?
I do. I don't have a lot. I have certain pre-mixes, but I haven't posted in a while. I normally post on SoundCloud. I have to update, but I normally post on SoundCloud. Mm-hmm. Yeah.
And when you're live mixing, mm-hmm. do you record in the moment or to make it a pre-mix?
Yeah, not every time, but for the majority of time, like especially if I know I about to mash this place up right now, I say, boy, I think I won't come back to this mix. I'll just press record and get it, like just save it for later.
So does that take a lot of work to record a live mix uh-huh. in order for it to be a pre-mix in the moment when you
DJ? No, not at all. You have a setting on Serato where you just go in recording, and once you press record, I just DJ in the same. The only difference is I record and that's all.
Okay.
So easy.
Right. Do you use external drives or cloud drives when performing, when DJing, and what are the advantages and the disadvantages of that?
I have used external drive before, and I use like just a drive on my laptop. Mm-hmm. The advantage without using an external drive, you don't have to worry about carrying that around and plugging that in, because that's like an mm-hmm. extra piece you have to plug in
right.
to the laptop. So I prefer the cloud drive, like just the drive on the laptop.
Okay.
So I prefer that over the external drive, because that's like an extra piece you have to carry around.
All right.
Yeah.
And the disadvantages? It's just an extra piece.
Yeah, well, that's a disadvantage right there. It's just an extra piece you have to carry around with the laptop. If you have everything on your cloud or everything in it already, mm-hmm. you just plug and play. Like, plug in and play. I mean, not plug in, but open up your laptop and play.
Okay.
Yeah.
So are you ready for any event? Like, you get called for a church event. You ready for that?
I am, because I DJ church events in the past. And to be honest, people might think, oh, it's all gospel, you just play all gospel, but they pretty easy. Once you have a few gospel, you could kind of like play some old school love tunes like Marvin Gaye and you know, like little R&B and stuff like that, and soca. So they pretty simple. I like DJing for church events. I like watching them have fun too.
Yeah, I can say something.
Yeah,
because
you do have, not everybody could be like, you know, but you have some people like they cool, like they just cool with everything. Once they know cursing and not too much hard dance all and whatnot. Yeah. Mm-hmm.
Horizontal.
Yeah. Yeah, exactly. And not too much hard trap and all of that. But they good. Yeah, I like them. I like them.
Uh-huh. Okay, so a little scenario question for you.
Okay.
You just got a new laptop. Mm-hmm. You've been called to do an event. Rush out the house. You forget your hard drive. Mm-hmm. You get there. Your phone on 1%. Your phone dies. What is your next move?
1%. Oh boy, that 1%. I only could be praying and hoping I could reach somebody at that moment, or just ask somebody who's their phone and call to see if I could get somebody to bring the external. But in the time, I only could be honest and tell the people what happened, and hopefully they could kind of
spare you.
Yeah, spare me and wring out the situation. It distract the people
right.
for a while until I get sorted.
Well, fair enough. It didn't make sense going through all of that.
No.
Okay, well, Shawnee, we're going to play a game right now, and the game is called the Whisper Challenge. I have to whisper a song, mm-hmm. and you have to tell me what I'm whispering.
All right.
Okay, you ready?
Yeah.
Sure. Ready? Sure, you know music.
We'll see how best I know it right now. Let's go.
So,
Boatman. I see that. I could see that. I could see that.
All right.
Hold on. Say that. Start over. Say that one again. All my life, they've been trying to keep me down.
Two in a row. Two in a row. No one ever had two in a row. You ever had two in a row? Never had two in a row. All right.
Which genre?
Bahamian.
Okay, go again.
We can have a bunch of things. Oh, I give up.
Boy, I think
you
I
give up on that one?
I get that one. I didn't get that one. I was a little lost just now, but yeah, I get that one.
Well, DJ Shawn, we appreciate you for showing up on The Drop. And we look forward to hearing more of you. But is there anybody that you would like to shout out before you leave?
I thank you guys for having me. And I want to shout out my girlfriend, Mimi. Aww. And my mom, Miss Butler, over Atlantis. Everybody knows who she is. So, but thanks for having me.
You're welcome. All right.
These niggas be watching me like a poster. I be getting money like I'm supposed to. See them so big it don't need no hope. Stuff. We gon' show, yeah. Hey, shout out to the guns that be toting toe. Stuff. Can't put it in a fucking hoe. Stuff. Come around here, if I don't know. Yeah. You play with squad, we standing. I be with a so popping and standing. They watch me like a TV when they watching Wendy. And if you talk about being stupid, this ain't plenty. If you love her, I'm just making up a remix. Come with me, pop em up, we ain't popping no Xanax. It's BNRS, BNB, HB, we lit it. Taking, see you watching me, they come to send me. I done seen all my haters inside the bitty. But I be running with getting a suit up and toe. Stress, don't come around my set of phone, oh, no. And I got n***a riding, don't need no show. Fuck 16 nigga, the one ain't nigga, man, fuck these hoes. Stress, hey, yeah. I ain't a shooter, shooters with me, hey, yeah. Don't play with squad, we stay litty, baby. They watching me like a poster. I be getting money like I'm smoke. Stuff, see them so big it don't need no hoe. Stuff, with my niggas, we gon' show, yeah. Hey, shout out to that be token toe. Stuff, can't put it in a hoe. Stuff, come around here, if I don't know. Yeah, you play with squad, we stay lit.
Shout out to that be watching all the pigeons that be flocking. All these Instagram that be seeking for some comments. 100K likes, I want the in my pocket. If I do it for the gram, I'ma turn. Couple pounds, run it off, flip it and bounce it. That's how Chulo gets down. If it ain't money, then it's up. Secure the bag like the airport, taking tote the luggage. I need a whole chicken, I ain't settling for nuts. Banks and belly by the blow, I thought I told. Just six in the clip, one in there, they need no hope. Stuff, and I'm married to the money. Yeah, I'm all about it, trying to get married to Oprah. And why these chickens watching me like I'm a poster? I'ma keep supposed to. You moving right, I do it wrong. You make love, but I'm drilling. I'll be so get sweat for a nigga getting a feeling.
Just be watching me like a poster. I be getting money like I'm smoke. Stuff. See them so big it don't need no hope. Stuff. But my we gon' show. Yeah. Hey, shout out to that be toting toe. Stuff. Can't put it in a hoe. Stuff. Come around here, if I don't know. Yeah. You play with squad, we stay litty. Be watching me like a poster. I be getting money like I'm supposed to. See them so big it don't need no hope. Stuff. With my niggas we gon' show. Yeah. Hey, shout out to niggas that be joking toe. Stuff. Can't put it in a f***ing hole. Stuff. Come around here if I don't know. Yeah. You play with squad, we stay litty. Hey, yeah. I ain't a shooter, shooters with me, yeah. From Blair Squad, we stand it in. I ain't a shooter, shooters with me. From Blair Squad, we stand it in.
Covering the news seems easy, but we put thought into what we're doing. The Bahamas Tonight Access Now. Here to inform, educate, and entertain. A new type of newscast featuring social media trends, news from around the islands, interviews with the people you like, sports, weather, and fabulous entertainment. That's a Bahamas Tonight Access Now with Marcellus Hall and LaDon Davis. Live starting September 16th.
You're watching The Drop.
Well, everybody, that's it for another episode of The Drop. It was very interesting tonight getting to know these two female DJs and what led up to them becoming DJs. Because, you know, that industry is more of a male-dominated industry, I'd like to think. But getting into the minds of those two DJs, it was very informative tonight. And on a second note, Devonte, I want you to know, I can zoom in for me. I do not forgive you for leaving me here like this. I don't. But that's it for another episode of The Drop, where the rhythm never stops and the vibes keep flowing. I'm your girl, Nika B. See you on the next episode. Am I saying that right, Taylor? The BPM?
You say beaten up?
Boy, you must have seen going by that. That's crazy.
All right, so. West Coast.